Okay, back to the code. That's our post object. Let's get to the actual main handler. So blog front is the handler for just slash blog. The first thing we do is we look up all of the posts. So this is blog front. This is our handler for the main blog URL. The first thing it does, actually, there's some leftover development code here. Let's get rid of that. The first thing this does is looks up all of the posts. Now, we've been using GQL to do queries against the Google Data Store. I was playing around here and I used Google's procedural language for writing a query. So this does, this says looks up all of the posts ordered by creation time and store them in the post object. We could have done GQL just as easily to get our posts. I was playing around with something new. So that's what I did here. And then this renders the front HTML template with this query, the result of this query in the variable posts. I'll show you all of the templates when we're done. I can also show you what the GQL for this line would look like. Let me go ahead and give that a try. Okay, I've changed that line to use GQL, the SQL that we've been playing around with. And that just looks something like this. Select star from post, order by, created, descending. And actually, I think I said 10 most recent, so it would be limit 10 is the SQL for doing a limit of 10. Let's go ahead and give this a try in the browser to make sure it behaves the same. I'll reload this page, and it does. Okay, cool. We use front.html, render our posts. Let's move on to the next one. This next handler is the post page. This is the page for a particular post. The way you look up a particular post in the Google Data Store is you first make a key. And in this case, I use the from path function. And it says, find the post with the ID, post ID, which gets passed in from the URL. I'll show you that in the handler definition. Whose parent is blog key? Now, you don't need to do this parent part. Because I create the blog with a parent, I have to look it up with the parent as well. This is how I did it. We call db.get, which is how you look up a particular item. And we store that in post. Now we see if there's not a post, just return 404, basically if the user typed in garbage in the URL. And if there is a post, return permalink.html with post equals post. There's a lot there. Let's talk about how post ID gets into this function first. If we go down to the bottom, past homework 2, you can see I've defined a couple of URL handlers. The main one, blog, is simple. It goes to blog front. Slash blog slash new post goes to the new post handler. We haven't talked about that yet, but that's all fairly straightforward. Slash blog slash and then a number, 0 through 9, plus. This is a regular expression for how to describe basically an integer. This goes to the post page handler. And this is how in App Engine you pass a parameter into the post page handler. Now, you may have done this differently, but this is how I've done it. This basically says anything in parentheses here will be passed as a parameter into either the get or post function for post page. So if we go back up to post page, a string representing that number gets passed in. That's why I call int on it. And I turn that into a key and I do the lookup. And then we call permalink.html. Let's see how that looks in practice. So here I've gone a blog slash 3, which was the ID of the last post we just entered. So this 3 gets sent into our function as post ID. We convert it to an integer. We make a key. And then we look up that key. So if I were to type in an ID that doesn't exist here, I get an error page. And now this is a 404, but Chrome is using this error page because I didn't send any content. You can make a special 404 page, but I haven't done that, so this is what we see. And if I were to type other junk that's not an integer, we get this different 404 page. Now, why did we get two different 404 pages? Well, because it went through two different 404 handlers. I'll show you that here in our editor. If we go down to our URL handler, this regular expression only matches numbers. 0 through 9, and then one or more of them. That's what the plus means. So that means that's going to go to post page. Now, when I just typed in the letters, this URL didn't match at all, and this whole block of code kind of fell through. None of these URLs matched. The WSGI application, the kind of the Web App 2 handler, the default handler printed their 404 page, which says 404 not found. When we go up to my 404 handler, if an integer is passed in the URL, we'll make it this far, and we won't be able to look up a post, and so instead, we'll just return error 404, but with no content. So that's why we saw that empty Chrome page. You know, normally we'd probably have a function called send 404 or something that, you know, has a prettier 404 with an image or that sort of thing. We'll go through all the templates at once.